here, Fido. Bring your birth certificate. Come on, Fido. Bring that birth certificate right over here. You stupid fucking dog. I asked you to bring me my birth certificate.
Oh, Frank, I was so stoned I couldn't keep that son of a bitch in my mouth.
Well, Fido, look here. Look here, boy. You know, when you don't do what somebody tells you, and this is especially true in a country like Sweden, if you don't do what somebody tells you to do, even though you are 15 years old, when you don't do it, you can be punished, and I do mean punished, to the full extent of Swedish law.
No shit, hurt me, hurt me, hurt me.
All right then, Fido. Yes, it's pain, it's anguish, it's torture, it's unbelievable, it's the 15-year-old age limit direct from Hollywood for Davey and everybody up there in the booth. Here it goes. Yes, he did. Yeah, he did. He wanted it to. Listen here. I want to give you all a lecture in Negroology. When God first made the poodle, he wanted it to be a schnauzer. But we all make mistakes. He fucked up, but don't hold it against him. When the poodle was first constructed, it was a good-looking dog. Many of us here in the ghetto. Didn't your grandma ever tell you about the poodle? Did she tell you about the schnauzer? What about the bloodhound? Well, anyway, the schnauzer itself would have been a much better sort of a thing to start the universe off with, because the schnauzer is a romantic sort of a dog. The schnauzer is the kind of a dog that never fails to bring a person of Germanic descent to orgasm upon contact with its tongue. But the poodle is a different story altogether. When it was first constructed, it had hair evenly distributed all over its charming, small, piquant, canine, moose pig type body. And then, Simba, God made two big mistakes. The first one was called Man, and the second one was the Swedish 15-year-old age limit. No, the second one was Woo Man. Now look, that's when the trouble all started. The Woo Man looked at the poodle and thought to herself, now this guy over here that I'm with is ensuring me such a good time. I mean, he's a nice person and everything, but you know, he never, well, his tongue is too short. What can I say? So she looked at the dog. Yes, she did. Would I lie to you? Does the Pope shit in the woods? All right, now look. His tongue, it's true, his tongue was too short. It wasn't more than about that long. But she looked at the tongue on this thing. She looked at the dog, and she said, no, he didn't. But he did. He had one. This was a very large dog when the world was first created. Now, the poodle has gotten smaller over the centuries. It has become more compact because there was less to feed it. As the women of our country get thinner and thinner, and all the good parts of their body just waste away, there's hardly anything to feed to a poodle anymore. How many say amen to it? Well, okay, at least he knows what I'm talking about. Now, look, the Woo Man, do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, about the
he does? He must have a little Eskimo blood, perhaps. Never mind. Well, anyway, the Woo Man looked upon the poodle and said unto herself, now this sucker could really do me if it got a haircut, because after all, I am very fashionable. I do know how to do the bump and the hustle, and I have been to Alexandria several times, and if my nose isn't up in the air like that, well then, Lord, please help me. So, and not only that, I have a pair of white plastic go-go boots and a hat to match, and I sure am something. So a dog that sticks his tongue on me, it better be something too. So I'm going to find a way to make this dog look good to me, you understand? Yeah. So she turns to the man and she says, go get a job, Jim. And Jim, as he was known in those days, Jim Jones he was called. Jim Jones got up off his booty and headed on out of the cave and went out and got himself a job pushing broom for about $1.298 an hour. He thought it was a good job. There wasn't any competition in that field, and he did take care of business. And he sort of liked the smell of that green sawdust stuff that they put on the floor. At least it wasn't a mop. He brought his paycheck back to the Woo Man, handed it right over to her, because that was the way of the world in those days. So the Woo Man took the money away from the man, clutched it, sort of, squeezed it, fondled it, sniffed it, and disappeared out the other side of the building, went out and bought herself a pair of scissors and a pair of zircon encrusted tweezers. And then she came back. She came back in. And she got a hold of that poodle, boy. Now, some of you may know already that Woo Man is a very artistic sort of creature. A woman is like sculpture. Now, she took the scissors and she started working on the dog. You see this part here? You people back here. Well, that's called the snout, the poodle snout, and she had to trim most of the unwanted hair from the poodle snout. This made it possible for her, in some of her finer moments, to grab the edge of the poodle lips. You know, the little black poodle lips that they have? She could grab the poodle lip and clutch at it just as the poodle was really getting down, so to speak. Then she took the scissors and just like cleaned them off right here in the medulla. Also in the thorax. The fetlock. The spotlight down lower, a little lower, please. The managua. Gradually working down, 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 all the way to Malmo, right here. During the last show, it was Copenhagen, but I figured I'd change it. And then, watch this. Put the poodle up on the side of the room and made the dog stick its little red tongue out and put its paws up like this. And then she took off her pants and went over and sat on the dog's face like this.
Your emotion, don't leave your emotion, we are the one man. I'm everything for me. I mean, why is it so hard to see my way? Why should I be stuck with you? It's just not who I want to do. Why should anybody choose to be myself to find? I know I do it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
she don't hear comedy was a present.